While appearing before Parliament's Finance Committee to present the 2024-2025 National Budget Framework paper, the Ministry of Finance officials indicated that the next financial year's focus will be on payment of debt so as not to attract interest from the lenders.
We are requesting for 23.9 trillion. The total is at the very bottom. I'll try to touch on some of the items here which are really increasing. Like the first item, that's interest. Loan interest is going up from 1.3 to 1.5 trillion. And the biggest drivers here are interest charges on Karuma hydroelectricity projects. It will take 385 billion in interest for the financial. And then we have the Afriexim, Standard Bank of South Africa. These gave us budget support. They will be taking a huge chunk of that interest amount because the amounts are big, the principal amounts are big.
The projection for expenditure on external amortization has increased due to huge principal repayments on Karuma at 950 billion shillings, Isimba Dam at 190 billion shillings, Kabale Airport at 108 billion shillings, Afriexim budget support at 218 billion shillings, Standard Bank support at 241 billion shillings, and TDB budget support at 365 billion shillings.
Just picked out the main ones. There are other small ones which build up to the 3.7 trillion.
The Ministry of Finance has also reviewed plans to inject 197 billion shillings into Voko Construction Company and Lubowa Specialized Hospital as part of the government's obligation to the payment of the four promissory notes for Lubowa International Specialized Hospital and two bills of exchange for Voko share purchase, because the obligations are projected to mature during the course of the financial year 2024-2025. The government is also planning to pay 247 billion shillings in 2024-2025 to the Democratic Republic of Congo in reparations for resources plundered during the UPDF deployment in DRC. A 2001 UN report found Uganda's army guilty of looting minerals, coffee, timber and livestock during an earlier deployment. In February 2022, the International Court of Justice ordered Uganda to pay $325 million, which is 1.234 trillion shillings, to the Democratic Republic of Congo.
There's that item on court awards, which is 287. This line has the ICJ, the annual ICJ, the International Court of Justice, the 65 million. And that will take almost 247 billion, and the balance goes to the regular court awards where our government has been taken to court.
However, some MPs raised concerns on domestic areas whose biggest victims are the local suppliers of goods and services to ministries and agencies.
This person there who supplied to Uganda, what is his hope? This is where, and remember, they used bank loans.
You cannot say the economy will grow as per the projected numbers and we are saying the revenue will stay the same. I see you projecting more or less no change in, I know that actually you've never realized the money you project.
The enactment of the Anti-Homosexuality Act has created external financing risks and uncertainty.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.